Hello, everybody. We are back, and it's Louisiana Tech playing their first conference game against Old Dominion, who lost their first ever Conference USA game in overtime by a field goal. That was a tough loss to take. You can see how the teams stack up. And here are some visiting prospects. Brian Davis, Caleb Jennings, and Brady Massey, possible future members of this team, hoping to be impressed today. You know, the team gets pumped up. We're going to get pumped up because it's a rainy, rainy, messy, messy day. And you know what happens in the rain? Crazy things happen in the rain. You never know. It gets slippery, gets messy. But hey, we like slippery, we like messy sometimes. And this team's ready to go. Louisiana Tech, though, they're 1-2, but one of their losses is to Stanford, a top 10 team. So we'll take their record with a grain of salt here. First play of the game. First and 10, Tyree Lee off to the left side for about 11 yards. Tries to get fancy with a little spin move. It doesn't work. So first and 10 there. Antonio Vaughn is going to get hit, and the ball pops out. The slippery conditions are already having their effects on this game, and it's going to be taken back to the house. But hold on a minute. There's a penalty flag. It's against Louisiana Tech, but it was thrown after the fumble was recovered, so the touchdown will not stand, but Louisiana Tech will get the ball on their own 38. So they are sent back pretty far from where they were, as in a touchdown, but Scotty Young, first and 10, they wouldn't complain about that. Trent Taylor, 16 yards, and it'll keep the chains moving. Scotty Young just evades Galen Evans' reach, and he just throws it into the ground. I don't know who he was trying to throw that to. That was one of the worst passes I've ever seen in my life. Third and 4, Young is going to find his man DJ St. Julian, but he will be about 2 inches short of the first down. And they're at the 36-yard line. It's at that point of too long for a field goal, too short for a punt, so they go for it, and they get it. Unbelievable. The Bulldogs will set up at about the 12-yard line after that play, first and 10. Going 5 wide receivers on this defense, and it's going to be stopped a few inches again. I mean, there's inches apparently are the name of the game today already, and Young back to pass has like a million years to throw, and luckily Keenan Terry comes in to make that play. Fourth and inches, and Louisiana Tech decides to go for it again. Looks like the defense might have him stopped, but he does barely get the ball across that line. It was incredibly close. And so first and goal, it's going to be Kenneth Dixon into the end zone. Touchdown, Louisiana Tech. So they do capitalize off the turnover anyway, just not necessarily from that return, of course, earlier that was called back. So Old Dominion gets the ball, and it's going to be a handoff to Tyree Lee, a 12-yard gain. Again, looks pretty familiar from that run we saw at the start of the game. Third and 10 as we're near midfield. Heineke's going to be pressured out of the pocket. And a poor throw. He does not throw well on the run, and that's what the defense wanted him to do, so it would be a punt, and the Bulldogs would get the ball right back. Not good for the Old Dominion defense, because they didn't get much of a rest. Third and inches now for Scotty Young, running the option here, and he's going to keep it and get it for first down. Old Dominion had the pitch man covered, but nobody really wanted to take the quarterback until he was well past the first down line there. So second and 10, Young has a man wide open, and it's Paul Turner, his star wide receiver. This guy is incredibly tough to cover. Luckily, Old Dominion does have a solid set of defensive backs to handle the load. So this time on an option, he pitches it to Hunter Lee, who is stopped a yard short. But once again, already got three times going for fourth down. Marcus Massey, the freshman safety, breaks up the play. He is having an outstanding season, and it is really showing. His future is very, very bright at that safety position. So Old Dominion ball, second and 9, and where is this going? This was thrown to Connor Martin on the little out route, but Heineke did not even see the safety there. It's too late to stop him because he takes it all the way, and there's no penalties this time, so it's a for sure defensive touchdown. And that is horrible start for Old Dominion. Two turnovers that lead to Louisiana Tech scores, and Tyree Lee continues to get big yards. You would think Old Dominion would just keep running him, because clearly Louisiana Tech's run defense is just not even that good at this point. So Melvin Vaughn, the fullback. He doesn't get many touches, but in this case, does. He gets forward progress for about 3 yards. It'll be a few inches short of the first down. As it seems typical in this game to just be inches short of everything. There's a flag on that play. Holding against the offense, so what would have been a simple first down turns into a dumb play by the least experienced lineman on the offensive line, Jay Franklin. He's done this before too, so there you go. And that completely screws the drive over and kills Old Dominion's hopes of getting within striking distance of Louisiana Tech. And now the Bulldogs, with under 3 minutes to go in the first half, have a chance to extend their lead even more. And this is just not looking good for Old Dominion. I mean, so far, it's just not been good to them when it comes to conference play. That unfortunate ending to Western Kentucky, my goodness, that was terrible. Well, it wasn't terrible, it was just unfortunate. And that huge play right there, a big hit, but nonetheless, it's a first and goal situation. But this time, Julian Randolph is not going to be fooled by the read option. No, 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 he gets right in the face of the quarterback. That is just superior defensive line play. Third and goal, and Young overthrows his receiver. The defense celebrates, though it wasn't really their play. So they would settle for a field goal, 17-0 with 1:35 to go. Javon Neal set to return the ensuing kickoff. And look at the block, he gets on the outside. What a block. He's got one man to beat. It looks like that might be the kicker, and he beats him out. Javon Neal, 92 freaking yards. Oh my gosh. This guy's a good, freaking good returner. I'm just going to keep saying that because that's what I'm going to do. So that was what they needed, because the Old Dominion offense can't seem to do anything consistently other than turn it over. So that keeps them in the game. It's a 10-point game with 1:23 to go. And that kind of made a little momentum shift, because Young is going to be sacked on this play. Great coverage as well. TJ Ricks getting in on that sack. 3rd and 4. 40 seconds to go in the first half. Young back to pass, and he's going to find DJ St. Julian. Keeps the drive going, and he gets out of bounds to stop the clock. One timeout left for Louisiana Tech. 2nd and 7. Young out of the shotgun, looking. He's going to be sacked by Julian Randolph, the team's leading sack man dating back to last season. That was a great play by number 48. So 3rd and 15. Very long yardage to go. Young dancing around in the pocket, and he finds Mr. Paul Turner for 17. This is ridiculous. The defense just can't stop this offense. 2nd and 1, but of course it's the last play of the half, so they're just going to throw long. It's been broken up by Reggie Owens and company on that play. Young ends the half with exactly 200 passing yards, not 2 passing yards. That would be even more impressive, actually. 17-7, Tech leads at halftime. So some adjustments need to be made by Old Dominion, and, well, the Bulldogs get the ball to start the second half, so serious adjustments are needed. And look at that play right there. Excellent defense by Larry Alston. That would completely stall the drive, so it's going to be Old Dominion ball and a chance to make this a one-score game. Lee gets the handoff out of the shotgun, makes a few guys miss, and gets 12 yards. He continues to get those huge first-down runs. It's just redonkulous. So 2nd and 5, Harvey Taylor, the backup halfback. He'll get increasingly more time as the season wears on, because he's proven that he can get some pretty big runs. So 1st down again, and Lee gets the handoff. Old Dominion deciding they just want to pound the ball right at the defense, because it's working. But on 2nd and 10, they run a little shotgun here, play action, and it's going to be Larry Pinkard wide open on a wheel route. That was glorious. Look at this again, a little play action, and then Pinkard, there's not a single guy close to him, except for when he makes the catch, of course, but that's not really important. So 2nd and goal, Harvey Taylor in at halfback again. He's going to cut it to the left side, and it's a 5-yard touchdown run, which makes this a field goal game after the extra point. Harvey Taylor should be excited. So just like that, Old Dominion has scored 14 points and made this all of a sudden a game. Suddenly it's just a completely different game. The momentum has shifted. 2nd and 6, the defense is all over that run. You see how they swarm? It's completely different defensive scheme this year, and it's working. 3rd and 6 for Scotty Young, dumps it off to his man Vince Owens, who only gets a yard. Sucks to be you, Louisiana Tech, except the next couple of drives by both teams would stall. So we jump to the fourth quarter, 6 minutes to go. Louisiana Tech is now going to be threatening to move inside territory of Old Dominion. But this play, I don't know what... Somebody explain to me what happens on some of these plays. The running back seemed to have bumped the quarterback too hard, and then he said, oh, I give up. I mean, that's just exactly what happened to me. And the defense gets caught off guard on 3rd and 14 by a screen play. My gosh, I hate that. I really hate that. But anyway, 3rd and 2, Scotty Young looks to pass, and oh, it's Paul Turner. Another touchdown he can add to his season. He is dominating at that wide receiver position. One of the best in the country, actually, statistically. And just one thing to note, Javon Neal would be injured for the rest of the game. 3rd and 4, out of the shotgun, Heineke looking, and what is that? This is exactly what's happened this season. Heineke is rated as a very good quarterback, but he's just not showing it. 1st and 10 on the next drive for Louisiana Tech, and it's going to be a broken up 24-14. They lead. They can put it, really just put the dagger in on this drive, but look at the defense stuffing Kenneth Dixon for a 3-yard loss. And this is still a game. 2:20 to go in the fourth quarter. If Old Dominion can score quickly on this drive, it could be anybody's game. Under 2 minutes to go. Heineke looking to throw. He looks deep. And no. No Larry Pinkard for you, says the defense. So 3rd and 5. You think they'd go for the first down, but no, it's going to be a deep ball to Blair Roberts, who does have a size advantage on that defender on the outside, and Old Dominion has no choice but to go for it, and it's Philip Dickens! Nobody's heard of this guy because he's been so low on the depth chart. He makes his first reception in this dynasty. That's a great moment. And then Antonio Vaughn, 16 yards on the play, the team's leading receiver in receptions this year. 2nd and 10, Heineke's going to find Jaquail Bailey, 24 yards and the touchdown, and it's still a game. Number one, he has proven to be a good receiver. I told you guys I like this guy. But obviously we have a couple of better receivers ahead of him. So it's an onside kick. Old Dominion only has 2 timeouts, so it wasn't going to be one of those see if our defense can stop them. And it was a horrible, one of the worst onside kicks of all time. I'm just going to say this right now. I am so bad at onside kicks in this game. I don't think I've ever in the history of playing NCAA football games, which is goes back to like 2000, I don't think I've ever recovered an onside kick in my life. Ever. It's so hard. I know it's hard in real life too, but it definitely happens in real life. Like, it's at least possible. But there you go, 24-21. Old Dominion drops their 2nd Conference USA game in a tough battle. I mean, Louisiana Tech's a pretty good team, especially offensively, but definitely wanted that win there. It was a tough game. And there you go, some game stats for ya. Old Dominion barely got over 200 yards of total offense. Outpossessed, out-first-downed. Louisiana Tech doesn't run the ball very much, so that doesn't say much when you look at their rushing numbers. But anyway, I'm being really pessimistic, but there you go. Players of the game for both teams. Old Dominion's offense was so terrible, there wasn't even an offensive player of the game. The offensive player was a defensive player who returns kicks. So, bada boom, bada bing, who am I? Look at this, Brian Davis, what a jerk. Not only does he go to another school, but he commits to Marshall, who is a divisional rival, who we will play later this season. They're a East Division rival of Old Dominion here in this conference, and Marshall is in West Virginia, so maybe we'll get a little Virginia-West Virginia rivalry kind of thing going on. I don't know. But there you go. Braxton Miller is tearing it up in his senior season. He is just ridiculous. And the Conference USA Players of the Week. Hey guys, remember Arius Wright? I liked that guy in my NCAA 13 dynasty. He's a pretty solid defensive back. But next week, it's the big one. Against defending national champion Texas A&M, I will see you guys next time.